Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Beers and Tears. Today, I'm joined with H3rizon. Hello.
Hello. So good to be here.
How are you guys?
Really good.
How are you?
I'm good, thank you. Do you guys want to quickly introduce yourself so everybody knows who you are?
Okay, I'll go first. My name is Bernie.
I'm Gabby.
I'm Taya.
Beautiful.
And we're H3rizon.
Yes, that's perfect. So there's probably a very simple answer to this, but H3rizon with a 3. Is it just because it looked cute? Like, what's the go there?
I mean, it's kind of self-explanatory. You know, we just wanted to be a bit different, you know, a bit quirky, because, you know, not many people have numbers in their name, do they?
Yeah, no, I love it. That's cute. Cool. I was like, it's probably just because it looks cool and I love it. And I was like, that's probably it. But yeah, I love it. It looks really cool.
But it's also like 3 kind of symbolizes an E, and for H3rizon we wanted to be H3rizon because, you know, we're women, we're all about
female power.
And so where did you all meet?
We actually knew each other through mutual gigs before, because we each performed solo a lot, and we knew of each other, but we hadn't performed together yet. But we actually came together for this one gig. Do you guys remember what it was? It was the Dream Girls. So that was our first sort of concept name. We performed a lot of songs from the movie and from the time period. So that was such a different like experience to what we go through now, which is cool. Like we have that range, but we decided to have a fresh start because we all had a passion for songwriting and for creating music, and we didn't want to miss out on the opportunity. So we decided, why not? Let's rebrand ourselves and become a girl group.
That's so cute. It's so interesting you said Dream Girls, because I was about to ask who your influences are, because it gives me very Dream Girls, sort of like the girls, like nostalgic kind of vibes. So yeah, who are your influences, or like where, besides Dream Girls, I guess?
It really ranges for us, I guess. Like, we're really influenced by the general girl group. So Spice Girls, we've got Destiny's Child as well. We all have our individual influences as well, because we come from very different musical backgrounds. But if we had to choose something, and I think the girls could say the same if we're reading each other's minds, we definitely say Chloe X Halle. They're definitely our biggest influence at the moment.
Cute. That's so awesome. And so, individually, when did you all kind of start like playing music or getting into music and realizing that that's what you wanted to do?
Ooh, let's go first. Okay, I'll just volunteer myself. As a kid, I was just very shy, very quiet. I didn't talk, and my parents were really concerned for me. So when they realized that I kind of had an interest in singing, they immediately put me in singing lessons when I was 7. And ever since then, I've just been immersed in music. Like, I've been learning piano as well, like doing gigs and that here and there. That's how I met the girls. And so, yeah, I guess now it's a full-time career, and I'm really glad that happened.
Oh, I'll go next. So I feel like I was a bit of a precocious child, and now that's all changed, because I started off with a lot of instrumental music. I played piano, guitar, flute, trumpet, E flat horn. What else? French horn.
Wow,
that was it. And I did all of that at once, and I'm like, how the hell did I do that? But do not ask me to play any of those instruments now, because I forgot. Anyway, somewhere in the middle of it, I finally decided on singing, and that was like the last thing on my mind. But now it's the love of my life. Like, I can't imagine myself doing anything else other than singing. Like, I also immersed myself into that with a lot of vocal ensemble songs, choral songs. I really love harmony, and I guess that really comes in handy with the group. And I also discovered a passion for music production in uni. So I definitely have a love for that as well. And I get to use that with our group, and we actually made a few songs with my own production. So fun times.
That's awesome.
Yeah. I guess for me, It was very simple for me. I spent most of my time in the backyard after school screaming my little lungs off. So definitely started from there. my mom noticed that I started, you know, being vocal at 2 years old. And then as time went by at around 10 years old, I was still going strong. So my mom's like, oh, I should definitely put her in professional singing lessons. And then from there, I spent about 10 years, you know, doing music competitions, spending time with girls. I was I had a solo career as well. And then I decided to join the girls and here we are.
Awesome. Do you prefer being like solo or do you prefer being with in as a part of a group, and what would you say the difference is?
I'll probably go first. I'll definitely say, you know, at first when I was a soloist, I was still lacking. I was still looking for my purpose. And now that I've met the girls and we all have, like I said, very different musical backgrounds, being able to complement each other, I definitely enjoy being in a group. It gave me the opportunity to find myself. And without these two, I couldn't do it.
How cute.
Bye.
I'm also go second. So like you can already tell, like through my love for vocal ensembles and choral stuff, you can tell that I thrive in group settings. So I could not imagine myself anywhere else other than being in H3rizon.
Damn. Well, I never really saw myself as like a solo singer. Like I've been doing music my whole life, but like I hated like putting myself out there and just being like, oh, I don't want to sing by myself. And then when I met with the girls, it was like, oh, I feel like I really fit in here. And I felt so much stronger being, you know, because you're stronger together than ever. That's how it always goes.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I just felt really confident in myself being around other people. And, yeah.
Cute. So you released a single recently called Serious. Yay. Happy days. Do you want to tell me what it's about and how it came to be?
Yeah, so it's the second song we actually ever wrote together when we started as H3rizon. So it's so dear to our hearts, and we wrote it like around 3 years ago, was it? It's been a while. So we were like, we were young. Well, we still are young, but we were younger then. And we wanted to write something that was fun and upbeat, and because we just didn't want to take life too seriously at that time, so we kind of wrote a song about, you know, being in a relationship where that person doesn't really get the memory that we just want to have fun, we don't want to do all these things, like we just want to live in the moment. Yeah. So that's why we came up with the hook, why so serious. So it's a message to all the people out there who just keep getting you down, like don't let it get to you.
I love that. Yeah. And whose decision was the Bratz vibe?
Ooh, I feel like we all came to that decision together, because we, to prepare for the release and the music video, we actually went full on PowerPoint presentation, present to the team. So we researched every single thing. Like we could tell just from listening to the song, the beat, it's got this like Y2K-esque vibe. And like, of course, we got to have some like Y2K-esque fashion in there, like the classic girl group music video vibe. Like yeah. you can see how we drew inspiration from the Spice Girls, from Destiny's Child, how vibrant and colorful the music video is. So we were fully and readily prepared to make this video.
Cute. I love it. I feel like it's so fitting as well, especially like the three of you looked so cute. Who directed the video? Like, was it a fun day on set? Look, the video turned out so well.
Yeah, it was definitely, it was over the course of 2 days. So we had a lot to shoot, but, you know, having the crew, we had Joel and Rowena Rasmussen who directed our video, and they were incredible. They just made it a good experience. And, you know, we had a lot of fun. That's the main thing when you're doing a video, you want to be in your element. You want to be yourself. And they definitely made that a fun experience. So, yeah.
Cute. And so, another one, because you've mentioned your harmonies, and I want to know, does it come like effortlessly, or do you spend a little bit time trying to like nail it, because they're just so spot on?
Yeah. You nailed it. It does take us quite a while, but whenever we come up with harmonies, each of us just kind of thinks of like a melodic line. We're like, oh, this kind of fits, or does this fit, and then someone else just chimes in, and then it just, I don't know, it just happens. Like, yeah. There's really no structure to it. We just
when it comes to yeah Sorry. Oh my God, I thought you were done.
Oh, no, I didn't say it. I wasn't going to say it.
No, what I was going to say was that when it comes to vocal arrangements, that's a whole new world. That takes time. But when it comes to like improving harmony, you know, the usual, that a lot of our ear training really comes in handy with that. So it's just like that for us, because we've done it so many times with each other and it just comes naturally.
Cool. Yeah, I love harmonies. They're just so precious and cute, and they just like make up every song. They're awesome. Yeah. What is your like kind of music making process like together now? Like, do you write together or do you write separately? Sort of, what's the go there?
It's a bit of a mix, I'd say. Being in lockdown, it's very hard to do things, but we're always communicating. Do you guys kind of want to like break down how we do it on a daily basis?
Yeah, so individually, we usually come up with ideas together. I even have my very own notes app that has like just a plethora of different lines and ideas and concepts that could be used in any like possible song. So I always jot down ideas in that. I know the girls also do the same. They also take the time to kind of individually do songwriting. But when it comes to songwriting day, we just come together on Zoom and just like jot down ideas, like go through all of our old songs as well.
Cool. And so you've signed to Bok Play, and I have so many random questions about this because I was reading and it's a crypto-based record label.
Yeah.
So what is the go here? I'm hoping you can tell me a little bit about it.
I did a little bit of research actually.
Oh, maybe I can speak the most on this, because like when we first were introduced to Bok Play, like it's like a whole different world. Like it's crazy like how things are just evolving so much. But yeah, we're so excited to work with them. Bernie, do you want to explain? Because I really can't.
So we sell NFTs on the blockchain. Oh wow. So NFTs stand for non-fungible tokens, and these tokens contain extra information such as art, music, etc. And that's what's happening with us. So for H3rizon, we'll let you in a little secret, where actually it's not a secret, but it's not really known at the moment. What we're doing, we're selling digital avatars of us, yeah, along with some singles from our future EPs. So that's a little bit of an insight into our
cool. That's awesome. Okay, and so have you got like more songs coming, that potentially coming out soon? Maybe
we do, but I think because we don't have a specific date yet or anything, we have more to plan. So I think we're keeping everything on the down low until we, you know, dive into it a bit deeper and then figure out exactly what we want to put out to the world.
Yeah, cute. And so for each of you, what would you say your favorite song that you've released is?
Tough one.
Mine would be Serious. I'm just a fan favorite. I mean, it's like, it's just a special song, and you know, it kind of has a lot of our different influences. Like my vocal composition was in it. That's what that little snippet is at the beginning of it. So it's just crazy that like something like that was just taken off my phone was just turned into a whole pop song. So yeah, special.
I feel like we're all gonna say the same.
Yeah.
Yeah, Serious for me as well. It's the second song we ever wrote together, so it's nostalgic to us in more ways than one, you know, not just the Y2K tap beat. It's throwback to our baby H3rizon days.
Do you feel like you've evolved heaps, like now that Serious is out, compared to like what you were sort of doing once you first started kind of being together as a group? Do you feel like you're like more set in stone now and like you've evolved more as a group?
Yeah, absolutely. I feel like, you know, we came from very different backgrounds and we were so young when we first started. And, you know, even up until now, we've had so much time to figure out exactly what we want to make, and we're still learning as we go. So this is definitely having Serious, you know, it's our second song, like the girls are saying, and it's our baby. So I feel like, you know, that song is like new beginnings for us, basically. We've had so much time to evolve, and this is definitely exactly where we want to start.
Yeah, beautiful. Have you ever felt like, you know, as a girl group and as like women in the industry, have you ever felt a little bit like, I don't know, because there's a lot of men in the industry, and like it's sometimes being like sometimes very overpowering and like unsettling. Have you ever like had, do you ever feel that way, I guess, being a woman in the industry at the moment?
Yeah, definitely, definitely. And especially as women of color, I'm coming from Mauritian and Filipino backgrounds, we're so strong about having more of this representation in the Western media, and especially as women, we definitely want to see more women just doing everything in the music industry. And like, we need to make a change, and the change has to be now. We actually were part of a campaign called Women of TikTok, where we expressed this. We were talking about facts. We were collaborating with other women around the world who felt the same way. We actually released a song, a cover of In the Name of Love in honor of that campaign. So yeah, it was just a really, really like empowering message and time for us.
Yeah, all in all, we just want people to realize there is space for women to make it in this industry, and we don't have to pit female artists together. Like, we can all make it, we can all uplift each other. It's not just men here, it's not just a man's club. Like, let everyone of any gender, any sexuality, any identity make it in this industry.
Yeah. I think that's so important as well, because I feel like now I don't really like, I can't really think of any like girl groups. Like, I guess growing up it was like Destiny's Child and like the Spice Girls, and they were kind of like very strong about empowering women, and like, you know, growing up you're like, oh wow, there's like a really cool girl group. And I feel like there's kind of a lack of that at the moment, so it's really cool that it's sort of like, you know, still in people's hearts to just to do it as well.
Yeah, we definitely want to see more girl groups as well in general, like not just female artists. We want to see female artists band together, because to be honest, there isn't really a lot of female girl groups in Australia. Like, yeah. We know there's G Nation as well, but we want to see more. We want more.
Yeah.
And have you had the chance to gig together at all since, more like before COVID, I guess, before the little lockdown situation?
Yeah, we had a few moments. We had some live performances, and we also had the chance to do a Zoom live concert. So still interactive in a way, before lockdown. So that gave us the opportunity to, you know, interact with our fans and people who are interested in our music. But yeah, at the moment, not too much, unfortunately.
Yeah. I do a little thing here. So you can talk about what you did solo or what you went as a girl group, but a little like a happy memory, a happy story playing a gig, and also something that's just gone horribly wrong and it's just nothing's worked out too well for you. So go for your life.
Gosh. I remember one. It was from the gig that Taylor's talking about, the Zoom concert. Because we went through the tech rehearsal, everything was fine, the music was playing, we're like so confident, yeah, let's nail this. And then it comes to the actual performance on our very first song, Arcade. We did a cover of that. At the climactic part, the very big part where all the vocals are strong and we're all in harmony, we're towards the end, the music cut out.
Oh, no.
But we handled it really well. We kept going. We were in key. We're still in tune with each other. And like, I even asked like my friends afterwards, after the concert, like, did you notice that that was a technical difficulty? And they're like, no, I thought it was meant to be a cappella at that moment. I was like, oh, thank goodness. So good. But yeah.
I love that.
Yeah,
do you have a story?
I was much gonna say the same thing as Bernie as well. I think we had the chance to redeem ourselves and it was perfect, like we pulled it off, so that's definitely a good and a bad moment as well.
Yeah, exactly.
My brain is maybe I think one of the best, well, it was like such a great experience, but it was so tiring when we were filming our Maniac music video. We kind of learned from that time with Sirius. That's why we decided to film on 2 days, but we filmed every single thing on one whole day from morning to like 12 or 1 a.m. in the morning, wasn't it?
Yeah,
for Maniac.
Yeah.
And we were just going at it, like scene after scene, like things were just happening. They were just rolling. And, you know, everyone was getting a bit tired, but everyone was just like, let's do it, let's go. And then main act just turned out to be so great. Like, I don't think anyone would have noticed we were pretty much tired half of the time.
I have been hungry.
Yeah, and hungry.
Oh, I can just imagine.
Oh yeah, right after after we filmed that, so our family, because our family was helping, I remember at the local McDonald's in the drive-thru, we didn't communicate this at all, but so my family went in first to the drive-thru. I turn around and Gabby's at the back and I'm just like, hello.
Hi. No, we didn't see anyone. We just saw each other at McDonald's.
I love that. And so with gigs kind of coming up, or like future gigs, have you got any plans for like cool visuals? Because I've noticed that visual and like style has like been very prevalent on your socials and stuff. So do you guys have any plans for like cute little outfits or like cool visuals?
Yeah, we definitely do. We have like whole Pinterest boards of our outfits, our makeup looks, our just whole like aesthetic. Like we're all pretty different with our styles, but like it's all kind of uniform. Like we just love fashion. We love like just being aesthetic. I mean, that's kind of what our whole generation is, right? Like we're all just exploring so many different venues in fashion and yeah, image.
Cute. Yeah, I'm very keen to see that and like just see it all plan out, because I've like even the whole Bratz theme and like your music video, it all just like looks so aesthetically pleasing, and I'm just like so keen to see all your cool fits and everything.
That's the goal.
So I do a little quick fire at the end of the episodes, so we'll go Taylah, then Bernie, then Gabby to answer them in order, and just say whatever comes to your mind first. So
yeah.
What emoji would best describe Sirius?
Probably the tongue with the wing face, that one. I definitely think that one. It's a bit spicy, it's a bit upbeat and fun, so definitely that one.
Love.
My emoji would be the screwed up face that's like,
yes.
What I'm talking about.
I don't know, for me, I'm thinking of the disco man. Like this? Well, I mean, it's not really a disco song, but like you just think like a party, like having fun. Like a
boogie. I love it. If you're not making music, what are you doing?
Eating and sleeping, if that's being truthful. Honestly, I'm spent most of my time eating, binging on Netflix shows that I need to catch up on, and mainly catching up on my sleep, because the girls and I have so much work to do during lockdown that I mainly try and catch up on my sleep during the day, and I have a few naps here and there. So yeah.
Cute.
My one would be, I'm so embarrassed to say, reading fanfics.
Yes.
I love it. I love archives of our own. They always pull through. They always come through for me. Anyway, we'll just go on to the next girl.
I didn't even think of my answer. I was just so interested in everyone else's. I don't know. I've been probably watching like really, really sad dramas, because I just love to make myself feel just, yeah.
Yeah.
You know?
I feel that. I relay. I've been watching Nashville lately, if anyone knows what that show is. And I literally got to the last episode last night, and I didn't expect it to be the last episode. It was like the last episode of season 6, and it came and I was like crying and I didn't know. I was like, oh my God, what do I do with myself? Like, what am I doing now?
Oh, I
get so emotionally attached. I was like, dude, I'm in this show. I'm in it.
So invested. Yeah, I get you.
What have you guys been watching on Netflix or on anything?
A lot. I mean, I have so many different shows. I'm trying to think of one that I would watch all the time. There's one that's a little bit old. I think it came out last year. It's called Grand Army. So I'm definitely hooked on that, and I definitely recommend. And I've been watching a few cop shows, if I could say. Have you heard of SWAT before?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's really addictive. So definitely those two would be my main.
Fun.
Check them out. Oh, for me, well, I've been watching Atypical. I need to catch up though. I need to catch up on the recent episodes. But yeah, that's what I've been really enjoying lately. I love that show.
I don't know if this is embarrassing, but I watch Korean dramas on Netflix. A lot of Korean dramas. I don't know if you've never got into them, but I mean, they are kind of different. Like, they're the only type of dramas I've ever watched, and I can't seem to just get on any other Netflix show other than a Korean drama. Because really? Yeah, like, for me, that people find them really, really cringy, you know, a bit like, oh, that doesn't seem realistic, but it's just so sweet. Like, sad. Like, why don't men like that exist? Why don't couples like this anymore? Why doesn't that happen for me? So
no, it gets like that. I love that. Okay, pineapple on pizza, yes or no?
I'm gonna say yes. Yeah, I'm neutral. I mean, I have to feel, I have to be in the moment, but yeah, I would say yeah.
Cool. What was your first concert?
Ooh, goodness. As a group or solo?
Either.
Or one that we've attended or one, yeah, that,
one that you've attended.
Yeah. Oh, my first one was Alicia Keys when she came to Australia.
Oh, that's
true. Really, really fun. And she's been one of my biggest idols since I was a kid. So it's really, really special.
My one was Pentatonix. When they first came to Sydney, it was amazing. We're really proud to say that Scott Hoying of Pentatonix now follows us. No, yeah, our life is circle now. It's just everything's connecting. Like, part of me would be so proud of me right now. But yeah, that was back when I was 13 or 14. I forgot, but it was such amazing experience.
Cute.
Well. I went to a One Direction concert. I was like a super fanatic about it. I had their posters all over my wall. You couldn't even see my actual wall. So definitely one day.
Honestly, have you guys been getting, my whole TikTok feed is Harry Styles concert videos at the moment. That's all it is. It's just him in that pink outfit that keeps scrolling. And I'm like, guys, why is it being rubbed in right now?
You've done that yourself.
Yeah. It's so good. Okay, pre-show pump-up song is?
That's a hard one. I have so many.
Okay, ladies, now let's get in formation.
Yes. I feel like it's a Beyonce song. It's always a Beyonce song. Like, yes. Literally, during our serious music video, we were literally playing Beyonce on repeat. And just feeling ourselves.
I love her. I don't know where it is. I think it's on Netflix. Of like her Coachella performance and like the doco. My God, I've seen it so many times. She's just so good. It actually hurts to watch.
It's a crazy performer. Like, I idolize her like on my own. She's just amazing. She's everything I think a performer should like be. Just the stage presence, the charisma, and then she has the vocals and the dancing. It's just amazing.
I know, it's wild. Favorite color. What's your favorite color?
Blue.
Purple. It's gonna change though.
Mine's blue. It's always been blue. I've never changed it.
Really? Blue. I never hear people say blue. I don't know why. But that's really cute. I love this. Yeah, it's always red for some reason. Everyone chooses red. I know, random. Anyway. And who is the messiest band member?
Maybe me. I would probably nominate me, because whenever the girls used to come over to my house before lockdown, I'd have clothes everywhere. And they have too, but my room is like saturated with clothing all over the floor. So probably me.
Beautiful.
I'm going to say the same. Hey. I'm not going to dub myself in today.
I love that. That was so cute. Thank you so much, guys, for joining me. It's been a pleasure having a little chat with you guys and getting to know you all. I'm very keen to hear all your new music and your new stuff as well.
Thank you. Thank you for having us. It was
fun. We loved this interview.
Oh, yay. Usually we do a little bit of a cheers. If you have whatever object you have near you at the moment, you can cheers it with me. Anything. Yes! Oh, the little octopus. Cheers, guys. Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers.